Hello students, this is your physics teacher and welcome to my online physics class. Today again we have come with a new topics, and it is a topics from the electrostatic chapter, and here we will try to find out an expression for the energy of the capacitor. So without further ado, let's start. So before starting the derivation, just I want to give some overview about the capacitor and the capacitance. So here is what is called capacitance. Capacitance, it is the ability of a conductor, it is the ability of the conductor to store the charge. It is the ability of the conductor to store the charge. So how it is happening? So matter is that, let us suppose this one is the conductor. If I am applying, so if I am providing some charge to it, okay, what will happen? The potential will rise. Okay. If I add more charge, the potential will rise more. But can I give the charge, okay, to an infinite value to this body? The answer will be no. Why? Because a time will come when the air, which is generally known as an insulating material, or you can say that insulator, the insulation of the air will break and the charge will be so high and the potential will be so high that electric spark will start in the air itself, and the immediate conducting material, here it is the ground, let us suppose this one is the ground. So a spark, through the spark, this charged charge will move to the ground, okay, so that the potential difference will decrease. So that way the insulation breaks. So we cannot increase the charge to an infinite value, because the insulation of the surrounding or the air will break. So it is not possible. But whenever we give the charge, the potential rises. So coming to the next things, the SI unit of capacitance is farad, but it's a very big unit. In terms of some smaller unit, we use microfarad, picofarad. Microfarad means 10 to the power minus 6 F, and picofarad means 10 to the power minus 12 farad. Okay. Similarly, femtofarad, 10 to the power minus 15 farad. And generally, we use the term C for indicating the capacitance, and the expression for C is equal to Q by V. That is the amount of charge required to raise the potential of a body by unity is known as the capacitance. Again, I am telling, the amount of charge required to raise the potential by unity is known as the capacitance. So coming to the next topics, actually, what are the factors that affect the capacitance? So altogether there are three factors, can be more than that, but the more important are here. The first one is that the size of the conductor, the bigger the size of the conductor, the bigger will be capacitance. And so if I have a tumbler of a glass, metal glass, and if it is a smaller, and there is another glass, then and that one is somewhat bigger, then the bigger glass will have the more capacitance. So size does matter. And the second thing is that the smaller the gap, the bigger the capacitance. Actually, this one is the diagram of a parallel plate capacitor. This plate is positively charged and this plate is negatively charged, okay, and they are kept separated by very small distance. Together they constitute a parallel plate capacitor, and inside what you can say, in between the two metal plates there remains air, okay, otherwise it can be dielectric, and insulating material is known as dielectric, okay. So whatever be the value, so if the gap will be smaller, then the capacitance will be more. And how? The matter is that capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor is simply epsilon naught A by D, where epsilon naught is the permittivity of the free space, A is the common area, common area, okay, between the two plates, and d is the distance between the plate. So if d decreases, of course the capacitance will increase. So these are the things: the gap, the area, common area, okay, and the size. So you must remember these things. The next thing is that the expression for the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor is simply C is equal to epsilon naught A divided by D. And this is the capacitance when the plate has the air. In between the plate there is air, then in that case C is equal to epsilon naught A by D, where epsilon naught is the permittivity of the free space. Now if there is a dielectric, then in that case C will be equal to epsilon A divided by D. Remember, so if I write C naught for the capacitance when the air is in the gap, and when the any dielectric is in the gap, then I write C, then just divide it, you will get C divided by C naught is equal to E epsilon divided by epsilon naught, and this one is actually a constant, and that constant is known as K is known as dielectric constant. K ko hum log kya bolte hum log? Dielectric constant bolte hum log. Remember, okay. So on cross multiplication you will find that C is equal to C naught into K. So whenever we introduce a dielectric in between the plates, मान लो मेरे हाथ में ये एक प्लेट है, ये दूसरा प्लेट है, इसके बीच में अगर मैं एक dielectric ला देता हूँ, then the capacitance increases by k times. Remember these things. So if the question is asked, or you can say that if the definition comes for the dielectric question, then what should be reply? You can say simply that it is the ratio of the capacitance of the material with the material in between the two plates to the capacitance of the same parallel plate capacitor with the air in between the plates. So it is the ratio C by C naught. C by C naught is known as simply K. Now again, if there is a isolated charge sphere, then what will be the capacitance? So C it is will be equal to 4 pi epsilon naught, simple, and the last term is radius. 4 pi epsilon naught it is multiplied by the radius. So this is the capacitance of an isolated charge sphere. Actually what happens, if this one is the charge sphere, so you know very well that there is no charge inside the sphere, the all the charge remains on the surface. And what is the potential at the surface? To find out the potential at the surface, we can assume that all the charge has been is concentrated at the center. All the charge, let us suppose the charge is Q, so all the charge is concentrated at the sphere, and then potential it is simply is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, and the distance of any point on the surface from the center will be equal to R. R means that, just write it capital R, okay, 4 pi epsilon naught R. Now just on rearrangement you will get Q by V is equal to 4 pi epsilon naught R. But what is Q by V? What is Q by V? Q by V, abhi hum logon ne sikha na, Q by V kya hota? Charge required to raise the potential by unity, it is better known as C. So ye simply kya ho jayega? Ye C ho jayega. So C is equal to kitna ho jayega? 4 pi epsilon naught R. So simply there is a term radius, okay, sometimes only radius is given and you have to find out the capacitance. Radius means that capacitance is given, you just need to multiply the radius with the 4 pi epsilon naught. Again you must remember 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 9 newton meter square by C square, okay. This is a constant value, you must remember. Now coming to the our main question here, we have to find out the expression for the energy of the capacitor. So right now if I write C, so C must be equal to Q by V as from the definition, C is equal to Q by V. Now if I put a little amount of charge on it, a very little amount of charge, the potential will rise, but that potential will be very much little. The rise of the potential will be very much little because the charge given is very much small. So in that case, we can write dQ charge is given to conductor so that potential rises by dV. So can I know the expression for the work? Do you know work? Work is actually W is equal to VQ. Remember, potential is defined as the work done per unit charge. So on cross multiplication we will get this one. So as the charge is very very small, so here in this case the work done will be very much small. dV into Q. Am I doing the right thing? No. Let us just differentiate it, okay? The potential and dQ. The charge, very small amount of charge has been given, so the work done will also be small. dW is equal to V into dQ. Now to get the total work done, I have to integrate the expression. Let us start the doing the integration. What will I get? dW is equal to integration of V dQ. But we know V is equal to, from here, just try to find out the V. V is equal to Q by C. Put it down. V is equal to Q by C. Now this is the integration. V is equal to Q by C. Now 1 by C will come out and the integrand will be Q. So what will be the expression? Simply it will be Q square divided by 2C. And this is the work done. That work done is just stored in the form of energy, and that energy is known as capacitor energy. So here let us suppose the energy expression is U. U will be equal to Q square by 2C. U will be equal to Q square by 2C. So U will be equal to Q square by 2C. Now we know that Q is equal to CV. Just put the value. See what happens. CV, C square V square divided by 2C. What will you get? I will get half CV square. Similarly, I can write the expression like this. Half CV into V. Now what is CV? CV here, see, CV is equal to Q. So I am getting half Q into V. So we have got three expressions for the potential energy stored in the capacitor. One is Q square by 2C. The second one is half CV square. And the third one is half Q. So all the three expressions actually indicates the total energy or energy of the capacitor, half CV square. Now if I am to find out the energy per unit volume, then how will I do? So let's start. We know energy is equal to half CV square. Now half CV square, no? Now if it is a parallel plate capacitor, C will be equal to epsilon naught A divided by D. Remember, just put it. Epsilon naught A divided by D. And what is B square? B is the potential. Now potential can be written as E into D, where E is the electric field and D is the distance. Simply multiply the electric field with the distance, you will get the expression V. So putting the value of V, I will get E into D and the square term, and half into epsilon naught A divided by D, I will get E square into D square. So in the numerator d square, and there is a d in the denominator, So of course it will cancel out and 1D will appear. Now what is A into D? A into D, if it is a parallel plate capacitor, this will be the positively charged and this will be the negatively charged. The distance between the plate is D and the area of the plate is A. So if we multiply area with the distance D, I will get the volume in between the two plates. Okay, volume of the plates in between the two plates. So simply the expression will be volume, and this is if I shift the volume into the left hand side, I will get energy per unit volume. Energy per unit volume is better known as energy density. I will get the expression like this. So energy density expression is 1/2 epsilon naught E square. Thank you.